The lesson on using Page Builder, we will be using it for our Seneca Journalism website. So let's just go to that at senecajournalism.ca/admin for the login page. And you should all have logins for each group. Some of you got usernames and passwords in Ron Waxman's classes. Those should still be active, so you should still be able to use those. At the very least, your group should have one just for your group, okay? So once you do that, log in, and log in as admin. You'll get to this, the dashboard, okay? From the dashboard, you can do a lot of different things. We're going to go to Posts, and we're going to go to Add New, all right? So we're going to click on Add New, and that will give you a screen that would allow you to put in a conventional story. The very first thing you have to do is put in a title, okay? Sample Page Builder. All right. So that, once you put in a title, it would automatically save the draft for you. But you should get in the habit of saving draft every time anyway, okay? So save draft is over on the side. Now, the next thing you're going to do is it will come up as uncategorized. I don't want it under uncategorized. Click on student work, click off uncategorized, okay? That way it'll be in a file folder that I can find, okay? Don't publish it at this point. You're just saving a draft, okay? The next thing you do is go down the side and set featured image, okay? So we need to use an image at the very top of the article. This will allow it to be displayed somewhere on the main page of senecajournalism.ca. Let's just pick an image that we already have. Oh, let's grab that one. That's a cute one. Means nothing, but you'll have a specific image for your article. Set featured image, okay? So that's done. Now, we don't want to do a convention article. This is what it would look like for a conventional article. We're actually going to use Page Builder. So you've got over on this side, you've got visual, text, and Page Builder. Click on Page Builder. Okay, you'll get to a page that looks like this. Now, in order to add content, you have to add a row. So you'll see across here, you've got Add Widget, Add Row, Layout, History, etc. Add Row. Click on that, and it defaults to two columns, 50%, 50%. You can have as many columns as you want. You can have just one, or you can have, well, that would be a little bit absurd, have six. I'm going to use three in this case, okay? So we'll go with three. Now, I want to change the size of these. I want the column on the right to be a little bit smaller, the column in the middle to be the prominent column, and I'll make this one a little bit smaller too, okay? So this is going to be the main article, all right? So now we've done that. We've got our three columns. That's how your page will be set up. Click on Insert, and there it is. Now we'll put in our first article. We've clicked on the main column in the middle here. In order to add anything, you have to click on Add Widget. You're going to have a whole lot of options here under Add Widget, okay? We're going to go to Site Origin Editor. This is the one you'll use for a lot of things. Click on Site Origin Editor, okay? Now, you click on that, edit, and it brings you back to a page that looks like a conventional article. So we're going to do this. This is the main article, okay? And we'll capitalize everything for, if I could type this, it'd be so much easier. Main article, okay. Now we're going to put in some content for the main article. I've saved some text. It's gibberish, some of my finest writing. And we'll just paste that in. Okay, so now you've got your main article, all right? Now I want to put a picture in there. So we're going to add a picture. We're talking about Professor Richard Waugh in this, so I'm going to move my cursor down to where I want to put the picture in. I'm going to click on this, and we'll get a headshot of Professor Richard Waugh. Make sure that the caption underneath any headshot you've got, make sure you identify the person. So it's over on the side, caption, should have the person's name. Insert into post, and there it goes. Now, I don't want it in the middle. I don't like that. I'm going to put it on the side, align left, okay? So I just clicked on the picture, and this menu came up. I could move it over to the side if I want, the other side. Okay, that's a little big, so I can just make it a bit smaller. It's a nice little headshot. Now, there's also a hyperlink in here. There's something very important that I want to talk about in here. This is the word that links to that, so I'm going to highlight that, and I'm going to click on the hyperlink option here, okay? And I'm going to put in the URL for that, which will be down here, hyperlinks. And I'm going to paste in the URL. Now, if I left it this way, anybody who clicked on that would be taken away from your article and would have to click back to it. I don't want that. I want it to open in another tab, okay? So go to the tools here, link options, click on that, and open link in new tab. Just click that, okay? Just highlight that, all right? And update. Okay, so now that's in there. Anybody who goes to that in your article will be taken to a new tab, and your article will still be there, okay? So we're all done with that. Okay, so your main article's in there. What does it look like? You can click on preview at any time, and you will see what it looks like. And you've got your main headline, sample page builder, you've got your feature image, and you've got this one article, but you've got two blank columns on either side. We need to fix that. Okay? So we'll close that, and we'll go back. Now, I have a whole bunch of great pictures. I've only got one picture in the main story, but I've got a whole bunch of great pictures. I want to create a slider. I want to show them all at the same time. Okay? So we're going to click on this column on the left, add a widget. Now, there is site origin slider over here. Okay, it's on the far side down at the bottom. Site origin slider. Put that in there, okay? And we're going to edit that. So, slider frames. This is what you want to add. So, let's say I've got four pictures. I'm going to add four frames, all right? To edit each frame, you just click on the frame, choose media. If you've uploaded the pictures already, we're going to choose the media, and we're going to choose that as the first one. Set media. Next frame, where'd it go? Next frame, we click on that, choose media, and let's pick another image. That's a great image. We'll throw that in there. Great. Next frame, click on that, choose media, and we'll grab, let's grab this one. That's a good action shot. Set media. And then the last frame, we'll click on that and choose media. And we'll grab, let's see, I'm sure we have another good image in here. Let's grab this one, okay? Set media. Okay, now, you've got four images in there. You can decide how long you want each image up for. It'll slide through, it'll rotate through each one. So you go to timeout, it's how long each frame is displayed in milliseconds, okay? 8,000 milliseconds, doesn't sound like a lot, but it is. So we'll cut that down to 3,000, okay, milliseconds. Done. Okay, so now we've changed the speed at which those images will go. Let's take a preview. Scroll down, and now you've got your images here, and they'll scroll through the images. All right, so that will continue to slide through, scroll through as people are reading the article. You can also control. You can change the images if you want. There's a go back to another image if you want. Okay, so that's those two columns done. Let's go back because we've got to do the third column. Now over here, you've quoted your expert, say, or your focus person several times in the article here, but they had some really, really great clips on video that you'd like to use. Okay, so you've got a couple quotes here, but you want to put some video clips in here. So let's highlight this one and add a widget. Now we're going to go down here to Site Origin Video Player, okay? It's down at the bottom here. Site Origin Video Player. Now, there are actually, let's say there are three clips that you want to put in there. You can duplicate and duplicate. So you can have three boxes in this, okay? The first one we're going to edit, and we're going to put a title in here. The title will actually be the question that you've asked, and the video clip will just be the answer, okay? So let's say the question was, what is the meaning of life? It was a lighthearted interview. Okay, we don't want it self-hosted. We'll have it externally hosted, okay? And we don't want to use embed. We're not going to show related videos. The video URL, it's like any article. All we have to do is go down here, and we'll grab the YouTube URL, copy that, paste it in, and that one's done. Now we're going to edit the next one. We're going to edit the next one. There we go. And how high is up? Deep questions. Externally hosted again. Take off those. The video URL. Where do I have my list of links? And we'll put that in there. Done. And number three. Why is this not There we go. And why is the sky blue? It was a really good interview. Externally hosted. There we go. All right. And post, put that in there. And you're done. Okay, let's preview this now. We've got our main headline. We've got our featured image. We've got our slider. We've got our main article. And then we've got all these nice little clips down here. Okay? So people could click on this and they would hear. Okay, nice clips. You can play all of those. They're not very long. This one's 51. This one is 36. I don't want to play them all. All right, now, this is great, except that I've got all this white space here and white space over here. So I'm going to put some more stuff in. I'm not satisfied. So I'm going to go over here and Site Origin Editor. Under the main article, I want to put another video in there. So I'm going to add a widget. Again, Site Origin Editor. Oops, I went on the wrong one. If it turns up on the wrong one, you can move over here, okay? So it's just there. All right, you can move them from box to box, whichever column you want it in. Okay, so I'm going to put it in the main one. Edit. And I shot some great 360 video of Pacific Coast Highway last year when I was on vacation. So I had to put in a 360 video in there because I just think that'd be kind of cool. And I'm going to go down to 360 video. We'll grab this. You should have learned how to do 360 video in Brandon's class. Put it in there. And there's your 360 video. Okay, done. That's good. We need something more on this side. I'm going to add another widget. And we'll go to Site Origin Editor. And I'm going to put a podcast in here. Because we've got a great podcast that we've created for this. So, great podcast. An original title. And podcasts, just like YouTube videos, if you've got it on SoundCloud, you copy the URL for it. Paste it in. It will autofill, and we're done. Okay, so let's look at what the site looks like now. All right. This is the main article. We've got our slider of images. We've got our questions there. We've got the podcast, which will play back here. And then we've got our 360 video that they can also look at. And look at that beautiful, spectacular scenery. 360 video of the Pacific Coast Highway. They can zip around and see the whole thing. All right. So that's a pretty rich multimedia presentation. You can shorten the article if you want and just put a hyperlink into another page that would give the rest of the article. You can add in some explainers if you wanted to put more in here, as there's a little bit of gap down here. You can put another article in here. You can lay it out any way you want, but this gives you the basics and how you can lay out a multimedia article, okay? There's a lot of content there, all right? A lot of different kinds of content. So once you've done all that, you can publish, and then you're done. There it is, and it'll be on the site. All right, we're done.